returning by the end of the week. So we're watching for that scattered shower action. And of course, we are now at a major hurricane, Category 3. Just within the same day it became a Category 1 hurricane, Melissa has now reached 115-mile-an-hour sustained winds. We're seeing the system continue on a track to the west. It eventually takes this turn to the north-northeast with 160-mile-an-hour winds possible just before it's making landfall. So we will see likely a track across Jamaica, and this will impact folks with mudslides, a potential for anywhere from 10 to 15 inches of rainfall. It continues on a track that'll go over the Bahamas and into the Atlantic Ocean. Now, the good news is it does not look like it's going to come for the southeastern United States. We're going to have big impacts, though, right along our coast. We're talking about high wave heights, rip currents, and high surf, especially Florida, too. They may actually see some of those tropical storm rain bands from Miami and over the Keys. So we're going to be watching for the storm. It's pretty big right now. You can see that eye wall here just getting better defined. We have 22-foot wave heights out there right near the storm center, 16 feet as we get closer to Jamaica right now. So a lot of folks preparing to help with that disaster that we're anticipating within the next 48 hours. All right, we've got 50s out there. The 7-day forecast stretches out with 60s on Sunday, 50s Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Better rain chances through middle of the week before we clear out with low 60s and below normal temperatures this week.